Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you how to remove logos from photos. So say you wanted to submit these photos to Adobe Stock, and you have to get rid of the logos because you can't submit photos with logos to Stock because of the licensing rights and things like that. So anyway, let's have a look at two different scenarios, and we're going to be using two different techniques. We're going to be working here with the boxing gloves with Brooke, with a person here, removing the logos from the clothing. And then we've got a badge here on this car that we're going to remove. So why don't we start with Brooke? So we're going to bring her front and center. And let's zoom in a little bit. And we want to get rid of this logo. So there's a lot of different ways of doing this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the methods that I think are going to work best for these particular images. So right now for this one, let's have a look at fixing it. So this is what I would do. I'm actually going to grab my lasso tool, and I'm just going to make a selection around this whole area here. There we go. So I just want to isolate that area, and then I'm going to copy this to a new layer. And the way to do that is just to hit Control J or Command J. And if we look at it there, you can see we've copied that to a new layer. So what we're going to do now is we're going to work on this. So I'm going to create yet another layer above it. And then what we need to do is get rid of this. Now, I'm thinking the fastest way to do this is not actually use the clone stamp, but is to actually just paint over it. So why don't we just grab a brush here. We're going to grab the brush tool by hitting the B key. And then what I want to do is set the hardness to soft, nice and soft. And I'm going to make this quite large. So what I want to do is I want to kind of follow the gradients of this in a very smooth way. So I don't want to use a brush that's too small. All right, so all we're gonna do is hit the Alt key or the Option key, and that'll give us the eyedropper, and just tap to select the color. So I'm just gonna paint across here. Let's make sure that I've turned this off for size and opacity, and we're just gonna paint across like that. So we're just gonna paint across there, and I'm just gonna hit the Alt or the Option key, and I'm just gonna keep sampling the colors here and just create this little gradient going across there to kind of match the colors of the image. Don't worry about going across the lines. And because this is kind of this reflective surface, this is actually gonna work quite well. Now what we wanna do is just kind of clip it to that area just for fun. So we're gonna hit the Alt key or the Option key and click, and then that's just gonna kind of clip it in there to that area. So the next thing we wanna do is turn everything else back on. And obviously we've got some work to do here. So we want to kind of blend this into here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select these two layers. I'm just going to hit Control G to turn it into a group. So we've got all of that together. And then I'm just going to paint it in with a mask. So what we're going to do is select a layer mask. So go down, choose the mask. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to inverse this mask. So I'm just going to hit Control I to invert it. All right, great. So now what we're going to do is just going to paint away the logo. So notice I zoomed in a little bit. I've got the layer mask selected. I want to make sure I have white selected on the brush, soft edge brush, and I'm going to make it just a little bit smaller here. And what I'm going to do is I'm just literally just going to go in here and I'm just going to paint over this logo. Don't worry, we've got a couple more steps to do yet. So I'm just going to go over the main part of the logo there. There we go. And use this left bracket key there to make the brush a little smaller. So I want to just kind of go in there for a slightly smaller brush. So we can just kind of go in those edges. Nice. Okay, so we might have some areas there. See, we've got this outline where we've gone over. Just hit the X key so that we're painting now with black. And then just make sure you go over those little edges there. Let me make that a little bigger. And I just want to make sure that those are showing. If you go too far, just come back. This is looking pretty good. Now, there's one thing you're going to notice here. If we look at this before and after, look at this. You can see there's a little bit of grain going on in there. So what we want to do is we want to match that grain. So what we're going to do is we're going to apply this grain right now. So we're just going to convert this to a smart object just by right-clicking and choose Convert to Smart Object. Now by doing this, now I'm able to apply this grain non-destructively to this whole area here. So I'm going to choose filter, noise, add noise. And we're going to add just a little bit of grain, maybe drop that back. So we want it just pretty subtle. And notice what I've done is I've chosen the uniform option, and I'm also choosing monochromatic. So we're just going to click OK. So now we can compare this with the grain. Yeah, it's looking good. I like that. If you didn't like it, because we created the smart object, you can just double click and it'll bring the noise back up, and you could change that amount. All right, so that's looking pretty good. So we've got one side, and now all we need to do is go to the other side and then just repeat these exact same steps again. Okay, so now all we need to do is add the noise again to match. So rather than going and creating a new noise filter, we can reuse the one we have here from the other one. So all we need to do is select it, hold down the Alt or the Option key, click and drag, and then drop it on that layer. And you'll see there we've duplicated that filter now. And there we go. We've been able to get rid of the logo on those boxing gloves. All right, let's move on to the second image here. All right, so this is what we want to do. We want to get rid of this logo here. So I'm going to create a new layer. And with the new layer selected, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the clone stamp tool. So we're going to select that clone stamp. And then make sure that we have all layers turned on for sampling. This way we can paint onto a new layer. Now I just want to let you know, sometimes you can make a selection around there and just copy those areas over, but I'm noticing it's a little softer here. See how the depth of field is changing? So it wouldn't work to do that. So this is why we're using the clone stamp. So what we want to do is we want to find an area very close to where we want to copy it. And I'm looking here as the closest. And so I'm going to hit the Alt key or the Option key and click to create a sample. Now you'll see that we'll be displaying, and we want to align that the best we possibly can. So let's go down to about there, and that's looking good. All right, so we're just going to go across here and we're just going to paint that first row back in. All right, let's go down here, and we're going to get a little bit there. And I notice there's a little bit of the reflection in there too, so let's get rid of that. Okay, so now we're going to go here and we're going to do it again, because notice how things are just kind of starting to warp a little if we try to continue with the same brush, see that? So we're going to create a new sample here, hit the Alt key or the Option key and click, and now we're going to go down on this end here and get this pretty close. There we go. And now we're just going to drag this down. And notice it's starting to warp a little bit there, so why don't we undo that? And sometimes you just have to kind of do it one little bit at a time. All right. So if we look at this before and after, we can see that we've covered up, but notice we've got a little bit of problems here. We've got some warping going on here that we need to fix. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to merge these two layers together. I'm just going to hit Control E, and then now we're just going to work on fixing these individually. So the way to do it is let's just make a selection, and I'm just going to do one of these at a time. So let's make a selection around here. And I'm just going to hit Control J, and that copies it to a new layer, and I'm just going to move it over, see that? And you can nudge it with the arrow keys to make sure you've got it pretty good. And now we're just going to need to slightly rotate this. And notice it's just, you know, a little bit of elbow grease at this point. And so let's grab the next one. Okay, not bad. So what I'm going to do now is I just want to mask those. So I'm going to select them and I'm going to hit Control G to put all of these into a group. Okay, so we've got a couple of things to do. Now we need to mask these. So I'm just going to create a mask and I'm just going to grab a black brush here. and we're just going to go to those ends, and I make sure that we've got our softness set, so that's a hardness of 0, so it's nice and soft, and we're just going to kind of dab those ends in there. See that? Just blending that in a little bit smoother. Nice. And then the last thing you might want to do is slightly adjust those tones, although they're looking pretty good. Why don't we just add a levels adjustment layer? So I'm just going to go here and I'm going to grab those levels. And let's drag it out so we can see how it's looking. Now we want to make this just affect that underneath. So you're going to grab that little clipping thing there. And now it's only going to affect that group. And so if we look at this, see there's our brightness values. We can just kind of play around with that a little bit. And maybe go back a little there until it matches. There we go, that's looking pretty good. It's very subtle, but if we look at this before and after, you can see how that blends in better. Now you know how to remove a logo from a photo, why don't you try uploading some to Adobe Stock? That way you can earn some extra income from your photos and also put them to good use. Hey, who knows, maybe you'll see them on a magazine or on a billboard or something like that. I'll drop a link underneath where you can go and sign up to become a contributor to Adobe Stock. It's super easy and it's free to join. So anyway, if you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget, become part of the Cafe crew. Hit the subscribe button right now. Add a comment, add a like, smash that like button into dust. And until next time, I'll see you at the Cafe.